is the echo.
1, 2, 3, oh boy.
Cool, that's just these boxes.
Yeah.
There's a delay going through somewhere.
One, two, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. This is Matt. 1, 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Hello. Goodbye.
Bring your friends. you can bring your
friends, you're
Ladies and gentlemen, we're happy to welcome you to Coleman Field at the USA Baseball National Training Complex for the 2023 National High School Invitational presented by the Greater Raleigh Sports Alliance. The NHSI brings together 16 of the top prep teams in the country to compete against each other in what has become the premier event on the high school baseball calendar. The Single Elimination Championship Tournament presents participating athletes with national exposure in addition to providing the opportunity for the best teams in the country to compete against each other. As no event currently brings in a level of talent from top to bottom that the NHSI promises, the eventual tournament champion will kick off their respective season with recognition as the top high school baseball team in the country. For more information on the NHSI, please visit usabaseball.com. And to follow along with all of the action happening here in Cary this week, follow at USA Baseball on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram, and at USAB Events on Twitter. All games at the USA Baseball National Training Complex are streamed online at usabaseball.tv and on our official YouTube channel at USA Baseball TV. Be sure to tell your friends and family who want to watch at home to tune in live. And today's championship game matches 2016 NHSI champion Huntington Beach High School against JSerra Catholic High School. First, please welcome Huntington Beach High School and their coaches. Head coach, Vinzi Madur. Assistant coaches, Adam Springsteen, Jeff Ruzecki, Brett Europe, Joel Bernstein, and now their lineup. Leading off and playing shortstop, number one, Dean Carpentier. Batting second, the designated hitter, number four, Lincoln Garcia. Batting third and playing first base, number 24, Rafi Velasquez. Batting cleanup and playing center field, number nine, Aiden Espinoza. Batting fifth and catching, number 28, Trent Grindlinger. Batting sixth and playing left field, number 31, Colby Turner. Playing right field and batting seventh, number seven, Bradley Navarro. Batting eighth and playing second base, number 56, Brian Trujillo. Batting ninth and playing third base, number 13, Tony Martinez. And on the mound for Huntington Beach, number 14, Tyler Bellarose. And at this time, we ask the reserves to join their team on the line. And now, please welcome JSerra Catholic High School and their coaches. Head coach, Brett Kay, and assistant coaches, Matt Ola, Will Rubicava, Dan Groot, Bob Ikes, and Brett Dawson. And now for their starting lineup. Leading off, the designated hitter, number 17, Andrew Lamb. Batting second, the second baseman, number two, Rizal Fujiwara. Batting third and playing third base, number 22, Trent Carraway. batting cleanup and playing shortstop, number 27, Jonathan Mendez. Playing first base and batting fifth, number 38, Dominic Smaldino. Batting sixth and playing left field, number 3, Charlie Caruso. Playing right field and batting seventh, number 16, Tyler Dunning. Catching and batting eighth, number 13, Brandon Chang. Batting ninth, the center fielder, Dmitry Sisitko. And on the mound for JSerra, number 39, Brody Purcell. And at this time, we ask the reserves to join your team on the line. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we ask that you please stand, if able, and remove your caps as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem. Thank you. Fans, first pitch is just moments away, so be sure to take this time to log on and follow at USA Baseball on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and now TikTok to get all of the latest news and updates from your national governing body for baseball in the United States. USA Baseball has implemented a zero-tolerance policy regarding abuse in sport with support from the U.S. Center for Safe Sport. In addition to creating base or baseball athlete safety education to educate and train athletes, coaches, and parents on abuse in sport, USA Baseball provides countless free resources to protect all minor athletes playing baseball in the United States.
We welcome you to Cary, North Carolina, where this afternoon is the championship game of the 2023 National High School Invitational. NHSI, here at the USA Baseball Complex on Coleman Field. This event is hosted by the Greater Raleigh Sports Alliance. My name is Matt Krause, alongside Kyle Straub. So glad you're with us on this Saturday afternoon. Two teams from Southern California, located just 15 miles apart from one another, square off today here in Cary for the right to be crowned the champions of the 10th NHSI. It's the Lions of JSerra Catholic. In the field first, wearing black, taking on the orange-clad Huntington Beach Oilers. On the mound, for JSerra, he's the right-hander Brody Purcell. Future USC Trojan is a senior. Big guy out there, standing 6'3", 205, and Purcell makes his first appearance on the mound for JSerra in this NHSI. Both of these teams 3-0 in this event that earned them the spot here in the championship game. JSerra victors over Santa Margarita Catholic 4-1, the final score yesterday in the semifinal. Simultaneously on field number 2, Huntington Beach was handling Bishop Gorman's comeback attempt. They earned the victory in that one 3-2, setting up this matchup of two teams like we said, just about 15 miles from one another in Southern California, squaring off here in Cary for the right to be crowned champions. If Huntington Beach gets the job done today, it'll be the second time in their school history that they've won this event, having previously won the NHSI back in 2016. Starting lineup for Huntington Beach, under the direction of head coach Benji Madure, looks like this. Leading off the shortstop, Dean Carpentier, DH Lincoln Garcia hits second. Batting third, the first baseman Ralphie Velasquez, Aiden Espinosa cleans up in center field. Trent Grindlinger will catch and hit fifth. Colby Turner bats sixth in left field. Bradley Navarro hits seventh, plays right. Brian Trujillo batting eighth at second base. Dre Martinez rounds out the order. Martinez batting third for Huntington Beach. Tyler Bellarose will take the mound in the home half of the first. So set for baseball here, Dean Carpentier will lead off for the Oilers. Brody Purcell set to go to work. Here for JSerra, seeking their first ever NHSI title in their second trip to this event.
Well, they got off to a quick start yesterday, and I feel like in tournaments, the deeper you get, the quicker that you can get out in front, the better it is for you. You're getting deep into those pitching staffs, and I know that you've got Purcell and Bellarose, a couple of guys who can go pretty deep. Haven't had any work when you're talking about Purcell, but it's the fourth pitcher for this team, so you're not dealing exactly with the ace of the squad.
Yesterday, Kyle, to your point, it was a four-run first inning for the Lions. They didn't score the rest of the way, but it was good enough to earn that 4-1 win. A one pitch on Carpentier bends to the outside corner for strike two, and Brody Purcell doing exactly what head coach Brett Kay would like to see. That's firing in strikes, jumping out in front. Carpentier's been a good table setter this tournament, 5 out of 10, couple of doubles, one RBI, plus a walk.
One of the neat things about tournaments like this is you've got two guys going against each other right now, looking to win a championship for their team. In a season from now, they'll be wearing the same uniform, though.
It'll be more of an adjustment for Carpentier. Bright orange to the red and gold colors of the USC Trojans. Wave and a miss. Good breaking ball. Purcell snapped it off, and Carpentier down on strikes to get the ball game going.
Coming to the plate, the designated hitter.
Good job mixing pitches, keeping the batter off balance there. You go to the off speed when you're ahead in the count, and you can get a swing and a miss on something that's out of the strike zone.
Lincoln Garcia strides to the plate next. Garcia, natural shortstop, a sophomore. Even stance for the DH here today. Garcia takes the first pitch from Purcell, a little bit low for ball number one. Defensively for JSerra, behind Purcell, Brandon Chang does the catching. Infield left to right, Trent Carraway plays third, Jonathan Mendez patrols short. Ayase Fujiwara back in the lineup, playing second base today. His third pitch is in there for a strike. Dominic Smaldino once again over at first. Outfield left to right. Charlie Caruso in left. Dmitry Sisitko patrols center. Tyler Dunning over at right. JSerra.
As much as you want to get off to a quick start offensively, defensively, got to play clean baseball in a championship-type game or in an actual championship like we have here. You don't want to give up those walks, those free bases, when you have errors out
there. Charlie
Caruso had to take two steps to his left to get in front of that liner off the bat of Garcia. It was well struck. But, Kyle, it's worth noting that on this bright, sunshiny day, the wind is swirling around. The flags that are out behind the left field foul pole at the moment blowing in from left. I don't know if the wind had any impact on knocking that liner down. Yeah, bouncing ball, hit out to second. Fujiwara handles the chance, tosses on to third. Strikeout, line out, ground out. Easy, 1-2-3, first inning for Brody Purcell. High fives and fist bumps from his teammates. Now JSerra comes to the plate for the first time in the championship game after this.
Just past the left field wall. Construction on the building, which will be home to USA Baseball's executive offices and include an indoor training center, is expected to be completed later this fall. Follow along with all the progress at usabaseball.com. And as the action heats up on the field, keep in mind that the concession stand is open on the concourse. Be sure to make your way back there and choose from a complete selection of Pepsi products including Aquafina bottled water, Gatorade, Pepsi, and Diet Pepsi.
It was a 1-2-3 top of the first inning for JSerra right-hander Brody Purcell. And now the JSerra bats come to the plate for the first time against Huntington Beach right-hander Tyler Bellerose. Second pitching appearance of this NHSI for Bellerose. Tossed three shutout innings, didn't allow a hit. Did walk three, struck out a pair.
All about recovery. You know, how quickly do you be able to get back to being healthy and ready to go out there on the mound? For some guys, it takes a day. Some guys, it takes 2 or 3 days.
So second action for Bellerose begins with a swinging strike against Andrew Lamb. And Kyle, Lamb is your prototypical table setter. You look at the stats and you see 0 for 8, and he's still hitting in the leadoff spot here in game 4 of the tournament. But three walks, including a really, really patient attack yesterday. Slider misses low. But the walk that he drew to begin the first inning of Saturday's contest that kickstarted the four-run frame there for JSerra, that was pivotal. Tags this one out to center field, backing up, now moving to his right and making the catch, Aiden Espinoza. This time, Lamb is set down.
Yeah, anytime you can get the leadoff guy on in an inning, especially when it's without having to put the ball in play, you're ahead of the eight ball. And more times than not, when you look at the statistics, that leadoff walk will come in to score. And that's exactly what Lamb did, actually, the first of four in the first inning for JSerra yesterday. You know, hits are going to come and go. So you look at 0 for 8, and he's had a rough tournament. But you're a leadoff guy. You got to find ways to consistently be on base, even when you're not being able to get hits.
Corner infielders pinch in for Ryusei Fujiwara, who fouls off the first pitch on a bouncing strike. Fujiwara started the game yesterday at second base, Kyle, and then we saw as the game went along, he was lifted after the first inning, had his uniform pants off, and looked to have some sort of medical device attached to the leg. His return results in a pop-up, high right side of the infield, and it's taken in by Trujillo, his counterpart at second.
Yeah, it looked like he had a TENS unit attached to his leg, which is just something that sends electrical shocks or electrical waves through a muscle. So maybe had some tightness or just a cramp, something they were trying to work through.
The third baseman, number 22.
Base is clear. Trent Caraway next. Caraway, run-ending third baseman. And the first offering from Bellerose upstairs on a heater, ball one. Defensively behind Bellerose, Trent Grindlinger does the catching. For the Oilers, the infield left to right. Tony Martinez is at third. Dean Carpentier at short. Brian Trujillo, who we saw make the play on the pop-up, is at second base. Ralphie Velazquez, USA Baseball alum, over at first. Colby Turner plays left field. Aiden Espinoza, who made the first put out of this inning, is in center. Bradley Navarro in right. 2-0. And Carey looks at it for a strike. Aspen for 2-2, now on Carey. Carey with 5 base hit. Fought. Pitch. Strike number Rose's first K of the afternoon is of the backwards variety. Dueling 1-2-3 innings, no score through one in the championship at the NHSI.
Running poles is a thing of the past. Mark Pro flushes waste while feeding tired and sore muscles without an ineffective jog through the outfield. Find him on Instagram or TikTok at the Mark Pro, M-A-R-C-P-R-O. USA Baseball will be offering exclusive action photography for event participants. Log on to usabaseballphotos.com and use the password NHSI in all lowercase letters to see photos from the National High School Invitational captured by our photographers. There you can order prints or even download a digital copy for your mobile device or to print your own images. Again, that's lowercase NHSI at usabaseballphotos.com.
One inning, six batters, no base runners. This matchup between two Southern California schools clashing in the championship game of the NHSI, the 10th edition of this tournament here in Cary, North Carolina with Kyle Straub. I'm Matt Krause. Glad you're along with us for this championship game on a blustery but still comfortable Saturday afternoon. Aiden Espinoza will lead things off for Huntington Beach, lefty hitting center fielder. Facing Brody Purcell. And Purcell's first pitch lifted foul for a strike, nothing and one.
You look around the ballpark now, and it's not a cloud in the sky, blue skies, sun. There's some wind, but a pretty nice day. You'd have no idea that earlier today there were storms that had hail, depending on where you were in the area.
Luckily, the forecast proved, Kyle, to be a little bit tamer than what was originally called for, but thus why all of the consolation action for today was moved to yesterday. 15 games across the four fields here at the USA Baseball National Training Complex.
A busy day for folks here in Cary. Yeah.
Just one game here today, though. Championship action. It turns out to be a beautiful afternoon. Espinoza sees it go up and away, ball two.
Yeah, and looking in the stands, one of the things that I really like to see is that with all of those games being played yesterday, people had reservations booked through this weekend because they expected to be here playing today in some sort of fashion. So no game, but they're still at the ballpark here watching this championship game.
Some of the other participating teams, that one catches the outside corner, two and two now. Espinoza, Trent Grindlinger, Colby Turner. 4-5-6, the middle of the Huntington Beach order this frame. Purcell from the stretch, 2-2. And fought off. We'll see another one to Espinoza. Second trip to this event in school history for JSerra. They were here in 2015. Huntington Beach, we've already told you, the 2016 champions of this event. They've been frequent visitors to the town of Cary, making the cross-country trek. 2-2 pitch. Espinoza stings it to short, played on a backhand. Scoop, good throw on to first. Nice play by Jonathan Mendez. Good reception by Dominic Smaldino at first, and it's a second straight ground out, four up and four down for Purcell.
Yeah, Espinoza put a good swing on that one. Sometimes it's just at the defender and you can't do much about it.
Much like the ball that Lincoln Garcia hit well back in the first inning. Was stung right at Charlie Caruso and left. So the base is clear and one down for Trent Grindlinger. Catcher for Huntington Beach.
Interesting look with the hoodie sticking out of the top of the uniform. Temperature's in the 70s. I guess the California kid's a little bit chilly still, though.
Well, if he was chilly, why are the arms uncovered?
I don't know. I don't have an answer for that one.
These are the mysteries of life. One ball, no strikes on Grindlinger. Weaves and misses. One and one now. 2-for-5 so far, but five walks so far in this tournament.
I love seeing that from guys that hit in the middle of the order. If it's not there, don't try and make something happen on a pitch that's not one that you can do anything with. take your base. Trust the guy that's in the lineup behind you to get the job done.
And on cue, he's ahead in the count, 2-1 here. For Huntington Beach, who has partaken in every NHSI since 2015, with the exception of the 2018 event. Champions in 2016. 2-1. In on the hands. Good pitch from Purcell.
A good location. Buried that 90-mile-an-hour fastball underneath the hand, so even though it's a hitter's count and he's getting the fastball that he wants, it's not in the location that he wants.
Two balls and two strikes on Grindlinger. Purcell trying to put him away. From the first base side of the rubber. And a foul ball fought off to the right. That one at 89. Special thanks to Pocket Radar for providing the in-game pitching velocity equipment used during NHSI games here at the National Training Complex. Pocket Radar, an official supplier of USA Baseball. Another 2-2 pitch on the Oiler catcher. Good eye. Count runs full. First full count that Purcell's experienced this afternoon.
Three straight fastballs. Kind of expect him in this situation to go off speed.
Three balls, two strikes. The Oilers dugout clapping rhythmically. And he catches the inside corner, freezes him for the second strike out of the afternoon.
Couldn't tell if that was a changeup or a curveball. Either way, bottom of it dropping out. That strike zone.
That ball four. Last second, in it fell for a strike. Colby Turner is the left fielder for the Oilers. He'll hit next. 2-for-6 with a walk so far. One run driven in the tournament. Slightly open stance before the 0-1 pitch. Bounces low. One ball, one strike.
One of the things I like from Purcell is that he just goes from the stretch. A lot of time for young pitchers, that's the way to go. It just simplifies everything, makes it easier to repeat that motion and release point.
It's something when he reaches the college level, if college coaches want him to work on going from the windup, utilize fall ball and that sort of stuff to add that to his game. 2-1.
I think you have to kind of work backwards. Get your pitches right, your release point, the feel, then start working on getting into a motion or getting more from your windup and delivery, which is when you go to the full windup, you can get a little bit more back on that rubber and push off with a little more of a little bit more behind you to get a little more velocity.
Off the ground ball foul. Two balls and two strikes with two down. Still in search of our first base runner of the afternoon in this championship game. Shallow right field on the fly ball, drifting back on this windy afternoon. The catch is made. Tyler Dunning is there shy of the track. Dunning was playing in. He had to track that one back against a cloudless sky and the wind, and he's able to make the play. Not as easy as that looks, for sure. A second straight 1-2-3 inning for Purcell. Six up, six down for the righty for JSerra.
Beaufort is offering customized rings to all teams, coaches, players, and parents at USA Baseball events. To view product offerings and to order your official ring, visit usabaseballrings.com. USA Baseball, with support from Major League Baseball, has created the American Development Model to provide a multi-stage developmental pathway for an individual's lifelong experience within the sport of baseball. Through developmentally appropriate programs for all ages, the ADM aims to promote age-appropriate physical literacy and psychosocial development, encourage age-appropriate skill development progression, and enhance enjoyment across the sport. USABDevelops.com for more information.
Pitcher's duel unfolding so far in the championship game of the 2023 NHSI here at Coleman Field in Cary. Huntington Beach and JSerra scoreless onto the home half of the second. Neither side has seen a base runner. Jonathan Mendez for the JSerra Lions leading things off, and the shortstop looks over an off-speed in there for strike one from Tyler Bellarose. Very economical. 10 pitches, 3 up, 3 down in the home half of the first. Bellarose, 5'11", 175-pound sophomore. He's already made his college commitment. Set to become a wave at Pepperdine. Pitch misses high, 1-2. Malibu, California. Mendez cuts and misses at it, and a second straight strikeout for Bellarose. Brings Dominic Smaldino to the plate.
38, Dominic Smaldino.
First one in for a strike, nothing in one. Future Bear for Cal Berkeley, the senior. Gets jammed, shoots it foul, over the net, look out. That one just barely cleared the netting, bounced up against the top row of the bleachers. No one ducked out of the way, though. Ground ball, worm burner to second. Picked up by Trujillo, wide throw to first, and we have our first base runner of the game. Smaldino aboard. Perhaps a roller that was a little bit slower than Trujillo was anticipating, and as a result may have rushed the throw, pulled it up the first base line, and the Lions have a man on. It is scored in E4. And Charlie Caruso will come to the plate with a man aboard. So Bellarose holds the set at the belt and deals. Outside, 1-0. Kyle, you know how you can tell it's a windy day here is the various buds and sprouts from the trees that surround the field here. It's blowing everywhere. Bouncing ball, hit to first, flagged there. Step on the bag for one, throw on to second, double play. Somewhat unconventional, 3-6, but just as quickly as the error is committed, Trujillo's teammates Velasquez and Carpentier pick him up. It's a twin killing, and the Oilers get out of the frame. Still scoreless after two.
Bag Tags, an official supplier of USA Baseball. Bag Tags is a provider of custom event credentials, lanyards, and luggage tags that are secure, distinct, and memorable. For more information, visit bagtagsinc.com. And fans, follow at USA Baseball on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter, and be sure to like and follow along for exclusive stories, photos, giveaways, and much, much more. And while you're here in Cary, don't forget to tag the USA Baseball National Training Complex on your post.
Thank you.
We're still scoreless as we head to the top of the third inning between Huntington Beach, the Oilers, designated visiting team in this championship game, and the JSerra Catholic Lions. Huntington Beach has gone 6-up and 6-down against Brody Purcell. Tall right-hander for the Lions, who has struck out a pair. In fact, Kyle, both innings, one strikeout, one ground out, one flyout.
I mean, if it works, why change it? Just keep on going with the same recipe.
Third baseman Caraway plays in just at the fringe of the infield grass. So the first pitch misses for ball one on Bradley Navarro, the right fielder.
One thing that we do have to keep in mind and keep an eye on as this game progresses for Huntington Beach, Bella Rose threw three innings in this tournament already. Not that it doesn't mean he can't throw more today. It just means that he's probably not going to be able to go the entirety of this game. So keep an eye on when they start getting somebody up in the bullpen, when their plan is to go there and get a new pitcher in the game.
That's a really good point you make, Kyle, because no arm for Huntington Beach has lasted longer than four innings in this tournament.
And I think part of that is the strategy of going into it. If you don't throw more than four innings, you're able to throw multiple times in the same week. Comes down to the question of which philosophy do you buy into? One pitcher for a whole game if you're able to do so, but then you don't get to use them for the rest of the tournament, or split it up. And as we say that, dual action in that bullpen, a lefty and a righty throwing.
It's the JSerra bullpen down the third base line. 1-2, upstairs. Yesterday, JSerra saw a complete game from Matthew Champion. Really effective, seven innings, allowed one run on six hits, struck out five. But the most important thing, did not walk a batter in his complete game victory. 2-2 on Navarro, forthcoming. Fouls it off.
No walks, that's the biggest thing to a pitching line. You want to know whether you had a good day or not? Start right there with that category. Did you put free bases on or free guys on the base? Because if you didn't, you probably had a pretty good day. It's really hard to hit. So stringing hits together to score runs, not an easy feat, which is why JSerra was able to hold on to that 4-0 lead after one and gave up just the one run.
Well, even that four-run inning for JSerra yesterday, it was four singles and three walks. It's not like they had big extra base hits or the home run or anything to, you know, put that crooked number on the board.
Yeah, and great for them for stringing together four straight hits. But that's probably only going to get you two runs because of those walks is why they're able to double it up.
Long at bat for Navarro against Purcell. Another 2-2 pitch. This one floats high. Next pitch will be the eighth of the at-bat and the 34th of the ball game already for Purcell. The limit in a single day is 105, so still a long way to go there, but still it demonstrates that while it's been six up, six down, it's not been the most economical. And sure enough, he misses low and outside, and it's the first walk in the last 2 days that JSerra's allowed.
Leadoff walk to boot.
Just the fifth free base of the entire tournament.
The second baseman, number 56, Brian Trujillo.
Bottom third of the lineup for Huntington Beach at the plate. See how they want to play this. Do you go small ball, getting that leadoff runner on base and try and move him around to get him in? Seems like runs are going to be at a premium in this game.
Well, Brian Trujillo coming to the plate. He's 0-for-6 with a walk so far in this tournament. And Trujillo swinging away comes up empty. So at least on the first pitch, no bunt.
I like that Purcell started him off backwards there. If the bunt is on, throw him a slider that's breaking down in a way that's harder to get down than a fastball would be.
Oh, one. Runner goes. Ball skips past the catcher, Chang, and no need to sacrifice to put Navarro in scoring position. He'll take second.
That is a great dirt ball read right there from Navarro. Saw the angle of it, took off, and because it's in the dirt, able to get down into scoring position, and now it changes the dynamic of this inning.
So a walk and a wild pitch has a man in scoring position for Huntington Beach. Trujillo hits a bouncer to the left side. Runner's got a freeze. Good throw over to first, and that's pretty much your best case scenario there for JSerra. You hold the runner at second base, and you put it out on the scoreboard. Well played by Caraway.
Caraway got that real big Baltimore chop charity hop at third. Did a good job of fielding it, looking the runner back, and then getting the out at first.
So here comes the head coach, Brett Kay, for JSerra. And with fist bumps for Purcell, it seems to be that his outing could be done here. No official signal to the bullpen yet, but you said it. Two arms up and going for JSerra.
Lengthy chat here. Going to leave him in.
Yeah, it was just a conversation about how to handle this situation. Purcell's going to stay in the game to face Tony Martinez.
You know, there's some coaches that will go out there and they'll have a chat with a player. I know one coach told me every time he went out, he put his hand on the pitcher's chest, and the point of it was so that he could feel the heart rate.
Mm.
I want to know what you're feeling and how you're responding to this situation. Not what you tell me, but I actually want to know.
That's a dead giveaway right there, body language. So Martinez, two out of six in the tournament. Looks over a first pitch breaking ball low. Navarro got a little dancy off of first, or off second rather.
Saw that ball kick away a little bit, had thoughts of taking third, but it just stayed a couple of feet away from Martinez. As a base runner, you've got to make up your mind. You can't be indecisive. You either got to go or not. When you're indecisive is when you find yourself out.
Hard bouncing ball back up the middle into center, a base hit. Navarro around third. Here comes the throw to the plate. A bit up the line, and Huntington Beach on the board first. RBI single for Martinez. He'll take second on the throw. The leadoff walk, yet again, Kyle, it comes back to bite.
You can deal with the single, but the leadoff walk plus the wild pitch that allows the runner to get into base scoring position out on the base pass, the reason you find yourself down 1-0 now if you're JSerra. Great job by Huntington Beach to take advantage of that opportunity. Number 9 hitter in the order coming through with the ribby.
After the first six hitters in the order go down 1-2-3 in both the first and second innings, it's this bottom third of the order that's gotten the job done. Purcell fires at a first pitch strike to Dean Carpentier, the shortstop. So first hit of the game, first run of the game. Both belong to Huntington Beach. Check back at second. Purcell ready. And deals. Pop-up foul for strike two.
Seeing both Fujiwara and Mendez, second baseman and shortstop for JSerra, doing a lot of running back and forth between second, trying to keep that runner close. You don't have to do that as a middle infielder, though. The occasional check on them. Go over, slap your glove, you can kick some dirt. There's a lot of different ways instead of having to waste so much energy with all the back and forth.
Yeah, there's a lot of movement out there, not only in the middle infield, but I've seen the outfield for JSerra shifting where they play over the course of at-bats, and it's a lot of running.
That'll come from the dugout, you know, how they're pitching to a batter. I don't know how much scouting they have, although these teams are only 45 minutes apart on the West Coast out in California. You have tendencies for a player, you're going to go ahead and have some shifts put on.
Wave and a miss at the breaking ball, and it's a third strikeout of the game for Purcell, second out of the inning.
That was a huge K right there for Purcell to get. Second out of the inning without the ball being put into play, so the runner at second cannot advance.
Even after the leadoff walk, who did come around to score, the ground ball from Trujillo had to have Navarro freeze. Now a strikeout, so all things considered, JSerra's done well to limit the damage. Still one more out to get, though, for Purcell. Lincoln Garcia comes to the plate. Hit a ball well to left field his first time, but right at Caruso. Swings at the first pitch, bouncing ball off the glove of Purcell. Right to short, though, and Garcia now has hit a ball directly to the left fielder and had a bounce go straight to the shortstop. That's baseball for you. Huntington Beach does strike for the first run of the game, though. RBI single by Tony Martinez. Scores Bradley Navarro. 1-0 Oilers, mid-third.
Only 2 more days to take advantage of Pocket Radar's upgrade program. Through the month of March, if you have a Pocket Radar ball coach, you can trade it in to save $200 on the app-compatible Smart Coach Radar. Visit PocketRadar.com to learn more. And the free USA Baseball app features the ability for users to plan practices using drills supplied in the application and access all USA Baseball education and athlete safety materials. Download the app today in the Apple or Android app stores.
Tyler Bellerose back to work for the Huntington Beach Oilers. This time pitching with a lead. 1-0 Huntington Beach. Thanks to a Tony Martinez RBI single, scoring Bradley Navarro in the top of the third inning. Bellerose will deal with the bottom third of the JSerra order. Just one base runner so far for the Lions. It was the one-out error that allowed Dominic Smaldino to reach in the second. It was promptly erased on a double play. So Tyler Dunning, the right fielder and seven batter, gets things started. Bellerose just misses off the outside corner. Dunning, Brandon Chang, Dmitry Sisidko. Bottom of the order for JSerra. Squaring to bunt, Dunning pulls it back, looks it over for a strike.
Totally fine with Dunning showing bunt there. First baseman is playing back. If you put it down, you do have a pretty good chance of getting on. But if you're going to show bunt and the ball's in the strike zone, you've got to be willing to put it down. Otherwise, you're just wasting a pitch.
Now he fouls that one off, and all of a sudden it's a 2-2 count. He's down in the count. Dunning just 1-for-7, couple of walks so far in this tournament. And the 2-2 lifted weakly to right field. Navarro fighting the sun makes the catch, one away.
It's going to be tough out there on the right side of the field, not just the sun, but the wind that you have to battle with as well. Good job using the glove. You see a lot of guys go out there, they have a glove, they've got a hat, they've got glasses, and the glasses will be backwards on top of the hat, and they won't put the glove up, and it'll fall in, and they'll say, what the heck, I couldn't see it.
You've got sunglasses out there. You might as well wear them. Otherwise, they're merely a fashion accessory. Balls against the catcher Chang, the second one he lifts weakly to Trujillo at second.
Bellerose has been impressive here, really kept these batters off balance, a lot of weak contact.
Just a sophomore already committed to Pepperdine. Dmitry Sisidko next. Center fielder will bat with the bases clear and two down. You ever seen pictures of Pepperdine's campus?
I have not.
It is perhaps the most beautiful campus in the entire country, right on the Pacific Ocean.
I probably have them, because I've seen some of the lists of the coolest baseball stadium settings.
Almost assuredly, Pepperdine's Field's on that list.
BYU is always one of the ones. Locally, App State in the fall. Mm-hmm. Literally just plop down in the middle of the mountains in the woods.
The front door breaking ball has been really effective against right-handed batters for Belarus.
Something if you're the JSerra batters, you got to make the adjustment to. He's going to continue to throw that pitch until you show him that you can see it well, make good contact, and put it in play. Now, the times that it has been put in play, we've seen a weak flare to the right side twice this inning already.
Next pitch. Swing and a miss, and Belarus strikes out his third hitter. A 1-2-3 bottom of the third. Belarus puts another goose egg on the board after his offense gave him the lead. It stays 1-0 Huntington Beach. On to the fourth.
No runners left on base. Have you checked out USA Baseball's educational resources at usabdevelops.com? Supported by Major League Baseball, USA Baseball emphasizes a culture of education, development, safety, and fun within the sport through online training courses and programs focused for players, parents, coaches, and umpires. Check out all of the educational resources today at usabdevelops.com or follow usabdevelops on social media. And Panini America is proud to be the official card of USA Baseball. Head to the usabaseballshop.com to order their latest USA Baseball product, Stars and Stripes. Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. Now pitching for JSerra, number 33, McAllister Zostowski.
Fourth inning of play in the championship game of this 2023 NHSI from Coleman Field in Cary. Matt Krause, Kyle Straub, glad you're on board with us on this Saturday afternoon. First time today that either team makes a call to the bullpen. This pitching change brought to you by Mark Pro, the trusted recovery device of over 200 major league pitchers. And the new pitcher for JSerra is the left-hander, McAllister Zostowski, senior, will take over on the mound and miss outside for ball one against Ralphie Velazquez. Heart of the order, 3-4-5 for Huntington Beach in this fourth.
Zostowski making his first appearance. Good frame, 6'1", 205, and a southpaw. Extreme first base side of that rubber.
It's going to make the ball tough to pick up.
Especially in a lefty-lefty matchup, that ball is almost coming behind the batter.
Mm-hmm. Hasn't found the strike zone on his first two pitches, though. Third one right down the heart of the plate, 2-1 on Velazquez. USA Baseball alum, played on the 2016 and 2017 12U national teams.
Had to come back that next year to make sure he get the gold.
Yeah. 2-1. Leave and a miss. Good pitch. 82. Zostowski. So Purcell is done after three innings. Gave up the one hit, one run, it was earned. Walked one, struck out three. 2-2. Swing and a miss, and a good job by Zostowski after falling down in the count 2-0 to come back and strike out Velazquez.
And after using a lot of off-speed, elevated that fastball. Don't need a ton of velocity when you're able to do that. It just it plays up when you're able to show them off-speed, slow, and then fast up in the zone.
And a big reason why Brett Kay, the head coach at JSerra, went to Zostowski out of the pen. Back-to-back lefties to begin this inning. Aiden Espinosa's next, 0-for-1 with a ground out to short. One nothing Huntington Beach. Tony Martinez, an RBI single to plate Bradley Navarro in the top of the third. That's the only run, only hit so far in this game. 1-0. Fly ball left field into foul ground. Long run for Caruso, and he makes a tumbling catch right in front of the tarp roller.
This may not be a field that they play on regularly, but they've played on it now 4 days in a row. And as an outfielder, you know there's a lot of foul territory. I love that he went in there. No worry about where the wall was, because before you get to it is a long way.
You and I had the discussion in the game yesterday, the JSerra Santa Margarita game, that because of how the tarp roller is stored here at Coleman Fields, there is a bunch of extra foul territory in that one little pocket down the left field line. It's a really long run to get there. But sure enough, Caruso just went into that cutout on a ball that, you know, if it was maybe 10 feet further back, would be on the grass berm. Instead, he's able to make the catch as the ball stayed in play. No balls, two strikes. Quickly on the catcher, Grindlinger.
I don't want to say you have to have reckless abandon, but as an outfielder, when you're going to a ball in foul territory like that, you a little bit have to understand where you are with the warning track, but also you can't really be worried about the wall. You got to watch the ball.
And that one hits Grindlinger. So he's aboard on the free pass with two down. Allows Colby Turner to come to the plate. 0-for-1 of the flyouts. All right, we will get a courtesy runner for the catcher over at first.
A little bit different than the free pass that was given up last inning, because that was to the leadoff hitter. You have a couple opportunities in order to get him around and get him in. Two outs, you can live with a hit batter like that. That's also a ball that, you know, if it's a different game and a different level, the college level, they may not have even given him the base on that.
Yeah, they may have ruled that he didn't get out of the way. And then would have taken it to video review and looked at it for a while.
Discussed it. Talked yep. about it with the coaches.
Yep. Talked about dinner plans while that was going on. By the way, the courtesy runner over at first for Huntington Beach, Trevor Goldenitz, future TCU Horned Frog. This game, as all games are at the NHSI, played under NFHS rules, that allows unlimited courtesy runners for pitchers and catchers.
Did you see the TCU, I believe it was them and Texas Tech score yesterday?
I did not.
I'm going to look up what the final was, but I saw it at one point, and it was 17-16.
Well, the wind must have been blowing. Pitching optional. Another toss over to first. That's three in a row.
So the final in Texas Tech TCU was 20-16, 36 runs scored in 8.5 innings.
Holy smokes. Who was the home team in that? Do we know?
Texas Tech.
Okay.
They were the ones who won.
Yep.
Who, by the way, is ranked in the top 25.
Yeah.
Still gave up 16 runs in a game.
Through the 5.5 hole it goes, and a base hit for Colby Turner. A little two-out rally brewing for Huntington Beach here.
And that's a good piece of hitting there, realizing you got a runner on, just trying to put the ball in play, hope something good can happen. You don't really get a great swing on the ball, weak contact, but it splits the left side.
So a two-out hit by pitch and a two-out single, and Bradley Navarro, who drew a walk last inning, will come to the plate. Chance for Huntington Beach to try and add to what's already a 1-0 lead. Feels like a big spot in this game.
Yeah, it really is. I think this is probably the biggest turning point you could have. Because so far, JSerra has really struggled to even put together a good at-bat to get a base runner on, let alone threaten. You go down multiple runs, you know, you're already into the fourth inning now.
One ball, no strikes. Two aboard already. Little pop-up, right field, Dunning, shading his eyes, moving over and squeezes it. Two base runners reach with two out. They end up being stranded. Halfway home, our score remains 1-0. Huntington Beach, if you like good pitching, this is the game for you.
On one hit, no error. batters and two runners left on base. USA Baseball would like to thank the town of Cary and the tireless work of its facility management team, including the grounds crew, for their commitment to first-class service. USA Baseball is proud to call the USA Baseball National Training Complex home, and we look forward to many more prosperous years working with the town of Cary. Hey, Sunflower Seed fans, Chinook Seedery is the official sunflower seed supplier of USA Baseball. If you're tired of the same old boring flavors, head to ChinookSeedery.com to grab the best seeds ever. You can try all seven delicious flavors for only $10. Chinook Seedery, taste the difference.
Still a 1-0 ball game in favor of Huntington Beach. The Oilers trying to earn their second championship at the NHSI in school history, having previously done so in 2016. Tyler Bellerose has mowed through the JSerra lineup the first time through, allowed one base runner. Wasn't his fault. It was an E4. And promptly, that base runner, Dominic Smaldino, was erased on a double play. So just as in the first inning, Andrew Lamb, the DH, leads off here in the fourth.
And in a game that is a momentum game and all about adjustments, what kind of adjustments are made by both the pitcher, Bellerose, but also the batters for JSerra? What are you going to do here now, second time through the order?
Well, Lamb's going to sting a fly ball to right field that sends Navarro back. Still back, it's over his head and will bounce up against the wall. First hit of the game for JSerra is a leadoff double for Andrew Lamb. His first hit of the tournament, and all of a sudden the tying runs in scoring position.
Ball elevated in the strike zone, went up and got it, and I think the wind blowing out to left. It's a little hard to tell without those trees out there moving right now, but I think the wind blowing across from left towards right help that one beat the right fielder.
And Navarro was playing in. He had a long run to get to that ball.
Yeah, looking at the flags down the left field line, just in foul territory. They're pushing across.
Ryusei Fujiwara next. Fujiwara, the second baseman. 0-for-1 with a pop-up to second base. Middle infielders play in for Huntington Beach. And Fujiwara will drop the bunt down. Runner moves up behind him. Bare hand, throw on to first. Well played. Good bunt defense by Martinez over at third. It's a sacrifice. They'll go in your scorebook 5-3. But advance Lamb to third. And put him in place for a potential sacrifice fly.
Sacrifice or not, that is a really good bunt from Fujiwara. You force the third baseman to make a barehanded play, and it's still bang-bang over there at first.
And so now Huntington Beach will have a conversation.
Yeah, just a conversation. There's nobody throwing in their bullpen, at least that I had seen.
Yeah, no activity down there. It's Bellerose's ball game. But when you think back to JSerra yesterday, they scored those four runs in the first inning, and so it has now been nine consecutive frames in which they've been unable to push across a run.
That's a good point.
And now 90 feet away from tying up this game, Huntington Beach put two on base with two out, unable to score in the top of the fourth. Now in the home half of the inning, an opportunity to potentially level up this game after getting out of trouble.
If you're Bellerose in Huntington Beach, you want either an infield fly type little pop-up or a strikeout here. See how they play the infield. Looks like they're going to play them in.
Corner infielders are in. First baseman Velazquez standing on the grass to the right of the cutout. Third baseman Martinez just on the fringe of the grass, middle infield to double play depth, even with the baseline. Trent Carraway, the batter, 0-for-1, a looking strikeout. First pitch fouled off. We'll say that in these righty-righty matchups, Bella Rose has already induced two weak pop-ups on the infield by jamming guys with that front door breaking ball. Does he go back to it here? Try and earn the out that way. See, 0-1. He was working in, nothing in two.
Remember Carraway last time up actually put a good swing on the ball. Just happened to be that it was right down that first base line, right to the bag, and induced the double play. If you don't have that runner on, I don't know that the first baseman's playing that close, and it's probably a double.
0-2, upstairs, trying to get him to chase, nothing doing.
It may have been a purpose pitch, too. Chase it, you're not going to hit it, cool, we're out of the inning. Or you get the strikeout you want, but if not, you've changed the eye level. Mm-hmm. Now got in it up, you can go back to that breaking ball down and in.
1-2 pitch. Just got a piece of it, 75.
Carraway was ready for it, exactly what they went for.
One ball, two strikes. Tying run at third. Back upstairs, 2-2 now. Jonathan Mendez awaits on deck as activity gets going again in the Lions bullpen. Bella Rose ready for his 2-2. Again, fisted foul.
This is where, as a pitcher, you got to go to your out pitch. What is your best pitch in your arsenal?
Another 2-2. Bouncing ball wide of third.
It's a really good job by Carraway just to continue to spoil pitches, stay alive at the plate. He hasn't gotten anything that he's really been able to put into play. Just a lot of foul balls.
But hands down, the most productive, lengthy at bat that JSerra's had in this game. Two, two. Popped up. Shallow left. Will it be deep enough? Shortstop back. Catch made by Carpentier. Runner holds, two down.
With the wind pushing that ball, that was not an easy play for Carpentier, but a good job to stick with it. And if you're Bella Rose, you can take a quick sigh of relief. You won that battle, but you're not out of this thing yet, though.
You still got the tying run at third. Any ball that gets through for a base hit.
And you see it so many times where you have an at-bat like that and you get the out, but then you let go a little bit and you give up the two-out single that'll score a run.
Well, Jonathan Mendez is 0-for-1 with a swinging strikeout. And the shortstop for the Lions will dig in. He'll look at the first pitch low for ball one. Andrew Lamb led off the inning with a double. He was sacrificed to third. Lions couldn't drive him in. The infield pop-up off the bat of Carraway. Now 1-0 to Mendez. Half swing, a little excuse-me swing that goes foul for a strike. Lamb takes his lead from third. The 1-1. Bends in beautifully for strike two.
Instead of going that front door like you've talked about so much, just throws a normal slider that breaks across that outside corner and into the left batter's box.
Now Bella Rose a strike away from stranding the tying run at third, keeping this a 1-0 lead for his Oilers. His 1-2 pitch. Check swing. Did he go? No. 2-2.
Got that one up a little bit too much. If it's down just below the letters, you probably get the swing.
at the belt, the 2-2 pitch. Breaking ball in the dirt, count full. Jonathan Mendez. Senior headed for UC Santa Barbara in a full count situation against Bella Rose. His pitch, bouncing ball, guided to short. Corpentier up with it, on to first. Jam, escaped. Leadoff double by Lamb, he's stranded at third, and the Oilers hold the 1-0 lead on to the fifth after this.
USA Baseball would like to recognize the Greater Raleigh Sports Alliance, an official sponsor of USA Baseball. For the past 13 years, the Greater Raleigh Sports Alliance has been a proud sponsor of USA Baseball, and it is pleased to extend that relationship to today's game. For more information on the GRSA, check out www.raleighsports.org. And launched in 2023, the USA Baseball Parent Certification Program is designed to enhance parent education and training with a focus on understanding how to recognize and respond to misconduct. The fundamentals of the American Developmental Model, arm safety for pitchers, and maximizing your child's experience in baseball. Visit usabdevelops.com for more information on this free certification. Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. Now pitching for JSerra, number 8, Andrew Padova.
This pitching change is brought to you by Mark Pro, the trusted recovery device of over 200 major league pitchers. Top of the fifth inning, and JSerra goes to the bullpen for the second time. Andrew Padova takes over. Padova becomes the third hurler of the ball game as his Lions left the tying run at third base in the last of the fourth. So onward to the fifth, and Huntington Beach trying to add to their 1-0 lead. That righty in this case, Brian Trujillo, the 8-hole hitter and second baseman, who grounded out 5-3 his first time. Just three combined hits in this game, including an RBI single from Tony Martinez of Huntington Beach, the home half, or the visiting half of the third. Huntington Beach, the designated visitors in this game. Game where runs are at an absolute premium. Trujillo gets his way aboard on a leadoff walk. It's a golden opportunity for Huntington Beach to add an insurance run, maybe play a little small ball. Yeah. ...3-0 pitch. And it hits Trujillo in the small of the back. So a leadoff base runner. And Benji Madure, the head coach of Huntington Beach, is going to call upon a pinch runner. Any starter can re-enter once. So if Trujillo turns out to be okay, then he come right back in and play second base, but it'll be Jet Burden.
Coming to the plate, the third baseman.
Your outfielder will run over at first. Tony Martinez, an RBI single, his first time up, right back up the middle. And we saw there that Martinez squared around. So now if Huntington Beach really wants to start playing chess, they'll have him swing away, but given the situation of this game, you presume this is a bunting situation, and that is the case. Martinez detons it, and it'll roll foul for a strike. So nothing in one. And you'd have to imagine that the bunt will stay on. Put it down, advance the runner. Burden takes his lead toward the edge of the cutout. Around, and it bends in for a strike. So now on 0-2, swinging away, Martinez comes up empty and strikes out. That's a pretty big response right there for the Lions and Andrew Padova.
The shortstop, number one, Dean Carpentier.
Dean Carpentier's played a really solid shortstop in the field today. He's handled some tough chances both on the ground and in the air. At the plate, 0 for 2 with a couple of strikeouts, but can change all of that in a hurry if he comes through. Leadoff hit batter as Huntington Beach threatening again here. First pitch slider for a strike. Ah. See, if it looks like a strike and stays a strike, someone's going to hit that. Probably pretty far. Yeah. And if it looks like a ball and stays a ball, well, a good hitter with a good eye is just going to let that one go. Two. Runner goes. Check swing. Fire down to second. Not in time. Plus the ball bounces away from Mendez. So it'll be a steal of second for the pinch runner Jet Burden. Still a 1-2 count on Carpentier. Lincoln Garcia waits on deck as the Oilers try and add to their lead here in the top of the fifth. Check back in the pitch. Swing and a miss, and down goes Carpentier. Big strikeout for Padova. Back-to-back Ks after the leadoff hit batter.
The designated hitter number 4, Lincoln Garcia.
Well, Lincoln Garcia's put a couple of balls in play, one to left field, one on the ground at shortstop. But unable to reach safely so far today, the DH for Huntington Beach. He'll stand in with a man in scoring position and two down. Get too much break on that slider. Ball one. Ball, no strikes. Garcia can't hold up in time. 1-1 now the count. Couple of strikeouts after the leadoff hit batter. Chang will set up away. Over will step off. Even stance for Garcia. Here comes the 1-1. Again, can't hold up. Oh, but the appeal to first said he did. So, 2-1. Mm-hmm. Another check back at second. That'll fall in for strike two. Just a steady diet of sliders. Now to the right hand of Andrew Padova. Finds himself a strike away from heading back to the dugout with this still a 1-0 game. Garcia fights it off, foul, drift out of play into the netting. Step back in and await another 2-2. Check back at second. And the pitch. Pop up. Foul ground. First base side. Smaldino moving over. It'll twist down foul. That had fallen in. Burden is for sure scoring from second base and making it a 2-0 game. So two balls, two strikes again. Pitch. Inside, ball three.
Padova in this situation, you got to realize you got to make a pitch, but you don't want to leave something fat in the strike zone. If you walk this batter, first base is open. It's not the end of the world.
Induces a bouncing ball to the left side. Gloved up, a throw on to first. Smaldino can't pick it. Garcia's safe. Burden stops at third, and it's men at the corners with two down.
That's a really tough play for the shortstop there to make.
Mendez had to range back and then fire it across.
And on the run as well, so he couldn't get everything behind it. Smart base running, because if that base runner from second hadn't taken off, you could have thrown to third, get the tag out to end the inning. But he had taken off with contact, so the only play for Mendez is to try and get it across the diamond. And they're going to check on the first baseman here, I think. Not the way he wanted it to happen, but Smaldino used his chin to stop that ball from getting by him.
And not only that, but it seems that the outing is done for Andrew Padova. And to the bullpen goes JSerra. So we'll step aside, tell you about the new pitcher when we come back here to carry.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. Now pitching for JSerra, number 45, Josh Hollis.
Welcome back to Coleman Field. Josh Hollis takes over on the mound for JSerra. This pitching change brought to you by Mark Pro, the trusted recovery device of over 200 major league pitchers. Second appearance of this tournament for Hollis. Five shutout frames, giving up two hits, one walk, and striking out two. So Hollis will go to work as the fourth pitcher. He will inherit men at the corners, two down, and Ralphie Velazquez at the plate. Lincoln Garcia reached on what's being scored in E6. And the pinch runner Jet Burden over at third. First pitch, bouncing ball, right side. Fujiwara, short route, one pitch, one out, inning over. Middle of the fifth, 1-0. Huntington Beach stays our score.
In the fifth inning for Huntington Beach, no runs on no hits. There was one error and two runners left on base. Luke Grips is the official bat grip supplier of USA Baseball and presenting sponsor of the USA Bat Guide. Luke Grips is offering a 20% code off exclusively for fans of USA Baseball. To receive the discount, use code USABB online at LukeGrips.com. Flip Give can simplify your team finances with their budgeting solutions. Earn cash back towards team expenses, balance the budget, accept fee payments, and more to help fund the rest of your season or next tournament. Learn more at flipgive.com.
Thank you. Well, the Huntington Beach Oilers have had opportunities to add to their 1-0 lead in both the fourth and fifth innings, but have left multiple runners aboard in both frames. So it stays a 1-0 game with Tyler Bellerose back to the mound. Only 48 pitches through four innings. Ran into his first bit of adversity in the fourth when he gave up the leadoff double to Andrew Lamb, but stranded him at third. So now Dominic Smaldino, the first baseman, reached on an error his first time. Takes strike one to begin this last of the fifth. 5-6-7 for the Lions. Bellerose working quickly. And Smaldino bounces it to third. Backhand, that's a fair ball. High throw on to first, and Smaldino will be safe. He'll take the turn. He'll head to second base. And second inning in a row that JSerra puts the leadoff man into scoring position right from the get-go.
So on that play, Martinez, if he was going to make the out, had to come in and charge that ball and get it on the short hop. He made the decision to back up and take it on the easier hop, the big hop. Eat it. Don't compound the issue by then trying to make a throw, throwing it away, and now you have allowed that first runner to get into scoring position.
Charlie Caruso. So out of the dugout comes Brett Kay. He's going to call upon a pinch runner. It'll be Jordan Marion. Marion will run for Smaldino. By the way, that'll be scored a single and an error. So Smaldino picks up the second hit of the game. Now here's Charlie Caruso, left fielder, 0-for-1 with a sharp ground out to first that turned into a double play. Corner infielders play in, and Bellerose will step off. Catcher Grendlinger goes to the mound, now retreats back behind the dish. Check back, and Caruso squares, pulls back, takes a strike. One. This time Caruso detons it. Grendlinger picks it up. He's going to throw to third, where they're going to get the lead runner. A heads-up play by Huntington Beach. And the first out goes up on the scoreboard as Marion is thrown out 2-5.
Really smart play from Grendlinger. Unfortunate there for Caruso. The bunt gets down, but it deadens right in front of home plate. That's such an easy play for the catcher to come up and fire to third. And the way that Huntington Beach had the defense played, third baseman wasn't crashing. They were keeping him home in case they had the opportunity to get that lead runner. That's a big swing of momentum in just two pitches.
Instead of a man in scoring position and nobody out, now the only runner aboard is at first, and there's one out. Tyler Dunning, the right fielder, has flown out to his counterpart in his one trip to the plate today. Middle infield at double play depth for Huntington Beach. A jam shot, fly ball out to left. Catch made by Turner, two down.
And for JSerra, this is the second inning in a row where you've got the leadoff runner in scoring position and still an out to go. Don't know how this will unfold, but looks like it's the second inning in a row in which you get blanked in that situation.
Coming to the plate, the catcher, number 13.
Brandon Chang, the catcher, will be next. Benji Madure, the head coach at Huntington Beach, made his way out of the dugout momentarily just to direct his defense. It's a 1-0 game. Both teams have had plenty of chances through these middle innings, though. For Huntington Beach, a chance to add to the lead. JSerra now the second straight frame in which they put the leadoff man in scoring position. And barring a two-out rally for the second straight inning, they'll fail to score. First pitch to Chang is a strike. Chang flashes the bunt, pulls it back, and takes strike two.
I think he saw the third baseman playing well back, Martinez. Thought maybe he could sneak one on him.
Three strikeouts for Bella Rose today, none since the third inning. He's ahead in the count, 0-2 on Chang. Strike three called. There's the fourth for Bella Rose, who's pumped up, headed back to the dugout. Second straight frame, JSerra puts the leadoff man at second base. Second straight frame, they fail to score. 1-0, Huntington Beach onto the sixth.
In the bottom of the fifth inning for JSerra, there were no runs on one hit. There was one error and one runner left on base. Did you know that 14 major league teams no longer use ice? Instead, Mark Pro has taken on the role of helping arms after bullpens, games, and practice. Learn more at markpro.com. MarcPro. Special thanks to PDQ, a restaurant sponsor of USA Baseball. For information on area PDQ locations and special offers, be sure to visit eatpdq.com or download the PDQ app. Thank you, PDQ, for your support of USA Baseball.
Still very much anybody's ball game. 1-0 Huntington Beach onto the top of the sixth. The Oilers have left four aboard over the last two innings with an opportunity to extend their lead. Now Josh Hollis making his second appearance of this NHSI returns to the mound for the Lions. He'll face Aiden Espinoza, Trent Greidlinger, Colby Turner.
The center fielder number 9.
We're 5-6 in the Huntington Beach order. Espinoza 0-2. Ground out to short, fly out to left, swings at the first pitch, lifts it up on the infield. Fujiwara backpedaling and underneath it for the out.
Ball traveled on him a little bit more than he was expecting it to.
So, if you're keeping track at home, that's two pitches thrown by Hollis and two outs.
Very efficient.
Induced the fielder's choice ground ball off the bat of Velazquez in the fifth inning. A leadoff pop-up here in the sixth. Trent Greidlinger struck out looking and been hit by a pitch today. Catcher for the Oilers fouls off the first offering on the hands. Hollis, the fourth pitcher of the day for the Lions. Brody Purcell started. McAllister Wistoski next. And Andrew Padova, now Hollis. 0-1. Almost hit him again. One ball, one strike.
Like Hollis pitching in, a lot of young pitchers are afraid to stay in to batters, but you really can command the strike zone if you pitch in and then move away with the breaking stuff.
Josh Hollis, sophomore and a future Duck, Oregon commit. One, one. Fouled off for strike two. It's working very quickly. Deals. Greidlinger fights it off. Foul.
Talked about ballpark settings earlier. I bet Eugene's got a nice setting.
Well, that's the shared ballpark between the Ducks and the Eugene Emeralds. Ooh. Minor league team for San Francisco, I believe. 1-2. Bends in for strike three. But yeah, you're absolutely right. In amongst the pines of the state of Oregon. Colby Turner up next. Singled in the fourth inning for the second of two hits for the Oilers today. He's also flown out to right. Hollis has that ball in his glove. He's kind of like Matt Champion, who we saw yesterday, who was ready to go as soon as the umpire gave him the play sign.
That, for me, as a position player, love that from a pitcher. You're ready to go. It means, one, you've got the mentality, and two, you're going to work quickly. You can get into a groove.
1-0 delivery. Turner shoots it foul. Colby Turner, future Aztec at San Diego State. We are about 5 minutes away from his future school, tipping off in men's basketball in the Final Four. And he hits a bouncer out to short. 1-2-3 inning for Hollis. Another chance for JSerra to try and tie this one up when we come back.
In the sixth inning for Huntington Beach, no runs, no hits, no errors, and no runners left on base. Funded Bat is an in-school bat and ball entry-level program for kids with an emphasis on character development, functional movement, literacy, active play, and fun. The program's goal is to promote fun and active lifestyles for children while teaching them the fundamentals of baseball and softball. To learn more about the Funded Bat program or to share this opportunity with the school or school district in your area, please visit www.funatbat.org. Want to stay up to date with all of the latest news from USA Baseball? Visit usabaseballnews.com and sign up to receive newsletters directly to your inbox about development tips, national team identification events, professional team news, the latest gear from the USA Baseball shop, and much, much more.
A 1-0 ball game that favors Huntington Beach, searching for their second championship at the NHSI here in Cary. Previously won the event in 2016. Trying to hang on to this lead against the JSerra Lions. Outs are dwindling for the Lions. Down to just six to work with. And they'll call a pinch hitter.
Nobody.
Flores, 6'295 pound sophomore, hitting from the left hand side against Tyler Bellerose, who has pitched a gem. And Flores lines one to the right center field gap. It'll dunk in quickly and fall for a leadoff single. So it's not a runner at second, which is how the Lions have started the last two innings, but it is a third straight inning with the leadoff man aboard.
I gotta love that from Flores, coming off the bench cold, getting a pinch hit appearance. Go up there ready to swing pitch number one.
And now Dmitry Sisitko will make his way back into the game to run at first. Andrew Lamb, the DH, smacked the double, was stranded aboard in the fourth.
Hardest hit ball from either side.
Number 18, Marcus Greece. Now batting, the designated hitter, number 17, Andrew Lamb.
Third baseman in, just in case they're going to lay a bunt down. That's Martinez for Huntington Beach.
Slider stays outside. Yeah, I was thinking about that, Kyle, but it doesn't seem like this is now the time to do that if you're JSerra, because you've got the top of the order up.
Yeah, that's exactly what my thinking is too, but still, defensively, you just want to make sure. And you don't feel like you're going to get beat by a hard ground ball because it's a lefty at the plate, so it's not a righty who's going to pull one past you.
Lamb disagreed with that call, but it's strike one anyway, 1-1.
If I read his lips correctly, he asked the umpire if that ball was down, and the umpire said it was in the strike zone, and he said, "You called that a strike?" He said, "Yes, I did."
Toss back to first, just barely back in there.
Maybe cut that lead down by a half a step. You haven't had a ton of base runners. If you're JSerra, tying run, you don't want to get thrown out.
Yeah, so Sidko is rolling the dice over there. One ball, one strike. Nobody out. Another toss over, this one higher up, and Sisitko is back in there. Lamb at the plate, Fujiwara on deck. One, one. Breaking ball stays well high. De La Rose, that was his 60th pitch in this first appearance of the tournament for him.
And there was some action in the bullpen last half inning when he was out there. Obviously got the strikeout to get out of the inning, didn't need the relievers, but they're still staying loose and warm for whenever that call is made.
Two, one. Fights it off. Championship game of this NHSI. Fourth game in 4 days for these two. JSerra's given up just four runs, three earned the entire tournament. Huntington Beach, no shutouts in their first three. They blanked the Lions thus far. 2-2, runner goes, pitch high, ball three, throw down to second base, is in time, got him! 2-6 in your scorebook. Carpentier puts the tag down, good throw from Grendlinger, and the bases are cleared out.
That's the second big-time play from Grendlinger. Remember last half inning, there was the bunt in front of home. He threw out the lead runner trying to take third, so really helping out his pitching staff right now.
And now a 3-2 count on Lamb. De La Rose, swing and a miss. Just like that, it goes from the leadoff man aboard and nobody out to bases clear, two down.
Big-time pitch there after staying down in the zone. Elevates a fastball. Got him to chase it. That was probably ball four.
Ryusei Fujiwara, 0 for 2, or rather 0 for 1 with a sacrifice bunt, stands in. Popped out weakly to second base, then dropped down the sacrifice that advanced Lamb in the fourth inning. Now he'll hit with the bases empty. 1 and 1. Not as much snap on that slider from De La Rose as the game has gone along.
Yeah, arm is getting tired. Body is just showing some fatigue.
2-1. Fujiwara fists it foul.
This is where you got to dig deep as a pitcher, though. You got a couple of more pitches you got to make to get out of this inning. You turn it over to the bullpen for those final three outs in the seventh.
Two-two pitch. Down goes Fujiwara. Back-to-back K's for De La Rose. And another zero on the scoreboard. Huntington Beach, three outs away from a title. Chance to add some insurance first, though. What an entertaining championship game this has been at the 2023 NHSI here at Coleman Field in Cary. Home of USA Baseball as Huntington Beach takes on JSerra. Huntington Beach three outs away from their second ever NHSI title, winning it previously in 2016.
Just two hits for them in the game, but we said it at the very top of this one. In a championship game, you got to take advantage of your opportunities. There's not going to be a lot of them. And the difference is that the Oilers took advantage of the one opportunity they had, got a single with a runner on second that was walked to lead the inning off, and that's the run. JSerra has had a couple opportunities and squandered them.
And that batter that drew the leadoff walk came around to score is at the plate now, Bradley Navarro. He's also flown out to right field for Huntington Beach. Insurance run for the Oilers would be huge here in this top of the seventh. 2-0 pitch from Hollis, who continues. Weak bouncer to the right side, past Fujiwara and into right field. Bradley Navarro has his first hit of the game and the third for Huntington Beach.
Didn't hit that one particularly hard, but just a seeing eye single.
Brings Brian Trujillo to the dish. Trujillo was hit in the back by a pitch in the fifth inning. Was pinch run for, then returned to the game.
You got to imagine in this situation, because it's the seventh, that the Oilers are going to play some small ball, try and move him over and get him into scoring position.
Because there is a huge difference between a 1-0 lead and a 2-0 lead.
Huge difference, mentally and the way that the inning is played when you get to the seventh.
Trio will square. He'll stab at it, strike one. Got to get that bunt down, though.
You don't want to stab at it. You got to catch that ball.
Hollis peers in. He's retired all four batters he's faced prior to this inning, then gave up the leadoff single. Deals strike two. To imagine the bunt would not be on for Trujillo here with two strikes.
I'd be surprised.
Pitch down and away, not bunting. Bottom of the order has been productive for Huntington Beach. All three hits coming from guys 6 through 9 in the order, and a walk and a hit batter in there as well. Only batter to reach at all today among the top four hitters is when Garcia got aboard via an error. 1-2 forthcoming. Navarro takes his lead at first. 2-2. Pop up on the infield right side. Smaldino has it. One down.
Big out to get right there for JSerra after the leadoff single. You retire the next batter, and that leadoff single still sits at first.
Tony Martinez will be the batter. Martinez, the RBI single in the third, and then originally tried to bunt in the fifth, wound up in a two-strike situation, wound up striking out swinging. Pinch runner now at first. Huntington Beach will call upon Trevor Goldnitz. Goldnitz has already appeared once as a courtesy runner, so now he's in the game as a pinch runner.
At the plate, the third baseman for Huntington Beach, number 13, Tony Martinez.
One down. How big would a double play ball be right here for the Lions? Toss back.
Now wonder if you get the pinch runner in because you try to swipe a bag to stay out of that double play. Also trying to get him into scoring position.
Bunt on, bounces back toward the mound. Hollis will go to second for one. Relay to first won't be in time, but a heads-up play, 1-6, and the lead runner is out.
I've seen two sacrifice bunts actually get put down, and the defense play them perfectly and get the lead runner.
The shortstop, number 1, Dean Carpentier.
Dean Carpentier comes to the plate, but will he be facing Hollis here? Brett Kay goes to the mound. Hollis now two innings of relief work, having recorded the final out of the fifth. And the answer is no. So new pitcher coming in for the Lions. We'll tell you about the new hurler after this.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. Now pitching for JSerra, number 37, Jaden Graves.
This pitching change is brought to you by Mark Pro, the trusted recovery device of over 200 major league pitchers. Jaden Graves, senior right-hander, takes over for the JSerra Lions.
Tall, lanky kid, 165 pounds, 6'3". A lot of arms, a lot of elbows, a lot of legs coming at you as a batter.
He will face Dean Carpentier with a runner aboard at first and two down in the top of the seventh inning, trying to keep this a 1-0 game and give the JSerra Lions a chance to walk it off. They can play two in the bottom of the seventh and just need one run, try and tie in force extras. Carpentier 0-for-3 with three strikeouts. Pitch is low for ball one. Inning began with a leadoff single by Bradley Navarro. Brian Trujillo popped out to first. Tony Martinez dropped a bunt down. JSerra was able to throw out the lead runner. Carpentier looks over a strike, 1-1.
About the toughest part of the day right now for a batter, too. Pitcher is in the sun, batter is in the shadow.
That's a good point, Kyle. 1-1. Here it comes. In there, strike two. One ball, two strikes, two outs. Just misses. For JSerra in the bottom of the seventh, it'll be 3, 4, and 5 in the order. Caraway, Mendez, Smaldino. A Lions team that has now gone 12 straight innings without plating a run. All four of their runs in the semifinal came in the first yesterday. 2-2. Swing and a miss. Down goes Carpentier. And the job is accomplished for Graves. Lions trying to rally. Huntington Beach, three outs away. Last of the seventh is next.
Pocket Radar is ushering in a new era in speed radar technology to transform the way players, coaches, scouts, and fans access and utilize key metrics and data. With the Pocket Radar Smart Coach and compatible app, Pocket Radar Plus provides unparalleled integration with leading scoring, streaming, and player development apps like Game Changer and Baseball Cloud. With new features like slow-mo video capture, pitch tagging, and video clips with verified embedded data, you can track, store, and share usable data from each athlete on your roster, enabling them to reach and sustain their highest potential. Certified accurate to plus one, minus one miles per hour by the lab that certifies all police radar, Pocket Radar is trusted and used by the coaches and athletes at the major league level, yet accessible to athletes and coaches on the field today. Use code USAB.
Well, here we go. A one-run ball game onto the bottom of the seventh inning. The Huntington Beach Oilers, three outs away from their second NHSI title in school history. The JSerra Lions, well, playing two runs, and they can walk it off as champions. Trent Carraway's 0-for-2. Tyler Bellerose is back to work and deals the first pitch strike. The leadoff man has reached for the Lions in three straight innings. Given that it's a 1-0 game, they failed to score in all three. 0-1 pitch. Carraway looks it over for a ball.
You hear people say every out counts the same, but it's just not true when you get to baseball. There is something about those final three outs, that last inning, that it's just tougher.
1-1, hit sharply to left. It'll dunk in for a base hit. Over near the line, cut off by Turner. Pulling into second base, it's a close play, and in there with a double, Carraway.
Really nice throw from the left fielder. Turner almost got Carraway at second. Maybe third time is the charm for JSerra. They've gotten a leadoff runner to second twice prior to this. Haven't been able to get him in, though.
Andrew Lamb was stranded at third in the fourth. And Dominic Smaldino singled and went to second on an error in the fifth. He was thrown out, trying to go second to third on a sacrifice bunt try. Jonathan Mendez will be the batter, 0-for-2, swinging strikeout and a ground out to short. Corner infielders will play in here for Huntington Beach. We will see if Mendez puts the bunt on. He does not. He's hit in the back. Now the winning run aboard for the Lions.
I feel like even now you still don't put the bunt on. You're in the middle of the order. You got your biggest bats here. Trust those bats to get the job done.
Dominic Smaldino has put two balls in play. He's reached from an error and singled.
Number 38, Dominic Smaldino.
Mound visit coming for the Oilers. No signal yet. This is not the head coach, Benji Madure.
A situation where you got a championship on a line. You want to go make sure everybody's nerves are calmed down, take a breath.
Yeah, Smaldino is the number five hitter. Back to your point, Kyle, this is a spot where I would agree you swing away here because you don't have those big boppers per se due up behind him.
Yeah, you've got the opportunity with your five batter at the plate to get a double. You know, put something in the gap, put it down a line. You put down a sacrifice and you're taking that possibility away, and a double in this situation could win you this tournament.
It's the second trip here to the NHSI for JSerra.
Now, the other thing is if you put a sacrifice down here, you're hoping that you've got two outs to play with in order to get a hit. Well, you only have three hits coming into this inning, so it's not exactly something where your offense is clicking and you're feeling real great about it.
Smaldino not bunting, takes ball one. JSerra's previous trip here came in 2015. They lost their first game of that tournament, but did go 3-1, winning all three of their consolation games. 1-0. Smaldino pounds it foul.
So the first game they played ever in this tournament is the only one they've ever lost.
Yep. They're 6-1 all time in this tournament. And now Here comes Benji Madure.
I think he saw the hard contact. We saw Bella Rose starting to labor a little bit in the sixth inning. And with the title on a line, you can only have so much rope that you give your pitcher out there before you got to make a move.
So, with a 1-1 count, nobody out, bottom of the seventh, Bella Rose is done. New pitcher coming in for Huntington Beach after this.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. Now pitching for Huntington Beach, number 11, Colin McNiven.
This pitching change is brought to you by Mark Pro, the trusted recovery device of over 200 major league pitchers. Second appearance of the NHSI for Colin McNiven. Two shutout innings, giving up two hits, no walks, striking out three earlier in the tournament for Huntington Beach. And he comes into perhaps the highest leverage of any situation possible. A one-run lead with three outs to get. Two runners aboard. Trent Carraway led off with a double. He's at second. Jonathan Mendez hit by a pitch. He's at first. Dominic Smaldino at the plate in a 1-1 count.
One of the things that I love about baseball so much is you've got this situation right here. Little guy, 5'10", 155-pounder out there on the bump, and a 6'6 dude at the plate. Neither has an advantage over the either.
1-1. Smaldino takes a strike at the knees, 1-2.
As a batter, you've got to adjust now. You've seen Bella Rose the entire game. You've seen the release point, the windup, the stuff. Everything is now different.
One ball, two strikes on Smaldino. McNiven's pitch hit weakly foul. Another 1-2. Fly ball tagged to center. Espinoza moving over. It'll fall in. Runners had to hold. Throw will go to second. There will be an out recorded there. Mendez is out. Men at the corners, one down.
Runners had to hold, Matt, but they didn't have to hold on the bag. You got to go halfway on that ball so that if it falls in, you're able to advance that one base. You're not going to tag on a ball that's going to be in right center field.
So, two on, one out, tying run at third, winning run at first.
The left fielder, number three, Charlie Caruso.
Charlie Caruso has grounded into a double play and reached on a fielder's choice today. A couple of ground balls off the bat of the left fielder. Quite obviously, turning two here would give the Oilers a title. but also Caruso come through and tie this game. First pitch swinging, fly ball, center field. Espinoza's got it. Tagging from third, Caraway. Throw is cut off, and we're level at one.
Caruso did exactly what he needed to do. Lift a ball, get it deep enough to get that tying run in from third.
So a 1-1 ball game. Tyler Dunning coming to the plate. Runner aboard at first in the form of Smaldino. Tyler Bellerose now cannot win this game. Cannot lose it either because Smaldino got his hit off of the reliever McNiven.
Now hitting number
1-1.
Marcus Greece.
Another 1-1 game. Can Dunning keep the inning going, or are we headed for extras?
A base running mistake, really big right now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it should have been bases loaded. And
no outs.
No outs. First pitch low for ball one on Dunning. First run for JSerra in their last 13 innings played. Two and oh. This is a pinch hitter for the Lions.
If this one doesn't end in a walk-off here, go to extra innings. Played straight up. I know there's a lot of different rules and have been a lot of different changes at different levels, but just straight up baseball.
Runner takes off, diving in there safely. Smaldino swipes second, and it's a 3-0 count.
And he stole that off the situation. Caught Huntington Beach sleeping out there. Really heads up play.
Catcher Brandon Chang on deck. 3-0. That's in for a strike, 3-1 now. But now a base hit wins this.
And you're not going to take here 3-1. You're going to look for something in your zone. Pick a spot, and if it's there, put your best swing on it.
It's Marcus Greece who's the pinch hitter. There's two number 18s. Pitch down and outside, ball four. So now two on, two out, Chang coming to the plate. Chang is 0 for 2. He's popped out to second and struck out looking.
No pinch runner for Smaldino. And if I remember correctly, they already did that once.
Yeah.
So if they take him out, not allowed to re-enter, and if you go into extra innings, now you lose one of your bigger bats. They are going to get a pinch runner over at first, though.
That's Dunning re-entering the starter.
Okay. Going to say, not sure why you're worried about getting speed. That run,
yeah.
I mean, you could take him off the base pass, basically. It doesn't really matter. It's the guy at
number
second.
16, yep. Cameron Maloney on first base. At the plate, the catcher number 13, Brandon Chang.
One-one ball game. Game-tying sac fly from Charlie Caruso. Chang takes strike one. Chang fouls it off, nothing in two. One for two coming into play today at this tournament. Two. Winning run at second. Pitch. Just up and away.
big, big gap in right center field with everything so far from McNiven being away to the righty. I'd be looking to shoot that gap. Especially with two strikes, defensive swing, let the ball travel.
Chang fights it off and stays alive. One, two. Bouncing ball, hit towards short. Throw across the diamond, and we go to extras. Lions level the score in the last of the seventh, but not enough to take the lead and win it. We'll play to the eighth.
In the seventh inning for the Lions, they score one run on one hit, no errors, and two runners left on base. Sports and Social Caring features a state-of-the-art 42-foot LED media wall and the next best game-watching experience outside of a stadium arena. Open daily for lunch, dinner, and late night. Sports and Social Caring is always raising the sports bar. Visit sportsandsocialcaring.com for more.
Well, seven innings, not enough to decide a winner in this championship game of the NHSI, so we go to the eighth. Jaden Graves back to work for the JSerra Lions, who tie the game in the seventh. They'll face 2, 3, and 4 in this Huntington Beach order. Lincoln Garcia, Ralphie Velazquez, and Aiden Espinoza.
The fact that there have really not been a lot of scoring opportunities for either side, somebody's got to come up to be the hero offensively. Both teams doing a good job of limiting those feed runners.
And Garcia, he's over. In the clock. And it feels almost now that here are extras. That it's been the Lions who have had the better scoring chances of late. They had all those opportunities through the middle innings. And a combination of mistakes and unable to come up with the clutch hit found themselves unable to score until the seventh. And quite honestly, it was the base running mistake in the seventh that maybe forced this game into the eighth inning.
Yeah, totally agree. They have definitely had more opportunities, not able to take advantage of it until that seventh.
One count on Garcia. Graves deals it low for ball three.
I do think Huntington Beach has a little bit of an edge, though, because they've only had to use one relief arm so far.
Yeah.
Game four of this tournament, eventually you're going to start getting low on who you're going to go to.
Graves is the fifth pitcher of the game for the Lions. 3-1. And Garcia draws a leadoff walk. Just the second walk drawn by Huntington Beach today.
But to draw that walk with middle of your order due to the plate afterwards, it's a big base runner to get to lead this inning off.
Ralphie Velazquez is next. Former USA Baseball 12U national team member, 0-for-3 in this game. But he's 6 out of 13 on the tournament. you could say he's due in this spot. Graves' pitch, well outside. The mantra for the Oilers now is make Graves throw a strike.
And there's going to be a quick pitching visit here. There is a righty throwing for JSerra. The way the coach ran out there, I don't know that they're ready to make a change yet.
Yeah, it seems like a settle them down conversation.
I've got to remember, these are high school kids. They're still learning how to deal with and how to cope and perform in these big pressure situations.
Especially on a stage like this one.
Mm-hmm.
One and nothing. Again outside, ball two. Same spot, same call, 3-0.
The runner now at first base is number 26, Will Bennett.
I said earlier in the game, sometimes with young pitchers, they can be afraid to be in the strike zone because they don't want to give up that big hit. But when that's the case, you end up giving up the big walk instead.
3-0 pitch on Velasquez. That's in there for a strike. Pinch runner over at first. Will Bennett comes in to run. And one. That's outside, ball four. Back-to-back walks issued by Graves. The go-ahead and an insurance run now aboard for Huntington Beach.
Huge opportunity for the Oilers.
This center fielder, number nine, Aiden Espinoza.
Got your cleanup hitter coming to the plate. Go-ahead run in scoring position. No outs. It looks like you're forcing JSerra to go to the bullpen yet again.
For a sixth pitcher of this game. Graves is done. New arm coming in for the Lions after this.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. Now pitching for JSerra, number four, J.J. Hollis. Now running at first base for Huntington Beach.
This pitching change is brought to you by Mark Pro, the trusted recovery device of over 200 major league pitchers. Second Hollis coming into the game for the Lions. It's J.J. Hollis, 6'4", 205-pound senior right-hander, future gaucho at UC Santa Barbara. Gave up three runs, two of them earned over two innings. Just one hit, walked two, though. in his prior outing. He will come into a game that's tied 1-1, but with the go-ahead run in scoring position. Back-to-back walks for the Huntington Beach Oilers to begin this top of the eighth.
It's just the second time in this tournament that, and it's been in existence since 2012, the second time since that very first year we've gone to extra innings to get a champion.
The designated home team is JSerra, so even if Huntington Beach scores here, the Lions will have a chance to battle back and walk it off in the bottom of the eighth, or keep the ball game going. Aiden Espinoza, the batter, against Hollis. Espinoza 0 for 3, ground out, fly out, pop out.
And you're looking for a double play ball or a strikeout in this situation if you're JSerra.
Hollis will step off. Now the pitch, Espinoza squares. Bunt goes foul, caught the hand of Chang.
Be honest, a bit surprised that with your cleanup hitter at the plate, you got him trying to lay down a sacrifice in this situation. I understand the thought behind it. Just disagree
yeah.
with it.
Maybe 0 for 3 on the game has something to do with that.
Yeah, but you can throw out what you've done in a game. Your last at bat of a game is the most important one, especially when you've got a situation like this. You get a 1 for 4 day with driving in the go-ahead run. Who cares about the 0 for 3?
Espinoza keeps the bunt down, bunts it foul again, strike two.
It's fallen away as he pushed out to try and stab at that bunt. Got to have a good, solid base, catch it softly. That's another part of it. The middle order guys, they're not used to bunting, so they're usually not your most reliable bunters on the team.
One ball, two strikes on Espinoza. Trent Grindlinger, the catcher, on deck. One, two. Cut on and missed. Hollis pulled the string and comes up with a huge strikeout.
Big time pitch right there.
Coming to the plate, the catcher, number 28.
Grindlinger has had a really big game for Huntington Beach behind the dish. See if he can translate it to the offensive side now.
Couple looking strikeouts and a hit by pitch in this game. Dream scenario if you're the Lions is to induce a double play ball here. Hit him again. Second hit by pitch of the game, and the bases are loaded.
A breaking ball that he never snapped off, just floated out of his hand.
So the sack's full and one down for Colby Turner, the left fielder.
Number 31, Colby Turner.
As a batter in this situation, you got to really take some deep breaths. Get that heart rate down so that you can stay composed and under control in the box.
Turner singled in the fourth. He's also flown out to right, grounded out to shortstop on this game. A fly ball gives the Oilers the lead. Base hit maybe gives them a two-run lead. Anything down the lines or in the gaps, looking at potential three-run advantage.
They got the corners playing in defensively. Halfway up the middle. Going to play for that double play ball, it looks like, if they can get it.
Pitch from Hollis. Turner, pop up, foul ground. Smaldino, underneath it, two away. So now the inning falls on the shoulders of Bradley Navarro. Walked and scored in the third, singled in the seventh. And JSerra one out away from him probably getting out of trouble here. On the flip side, if Navarro comes through, he can give his Oilers the lead back. Hollis peers in. Navarro, bouncing ball. Fujiwara on to first, tightrope, walked. What an escape job for the Lions. Now they'll try and win it after this. This pitching change is brought to you by Mark Pro, the trusted recovery device of over 200 major league pitchers. First appearance on the bump this tournament for Huntington Beach. Right-hander Otto Espinoza, 6'160" sophomore. He'll face 9-1-2 in the JSerra Lion lineup. Begins with Dmitry Sisitko, the center fielder. Singled his last time up, takes strike one here. One Lion run, and they win the ball game.
No time like bottom of the eighth, extra innings of the championship game to make your debut of the tournament on the mound. No pressure.
Well, he's ahead in the count, nothing in two. The Oilers loaded the bases with one out in the top of the eighth, could not score. JSerra squandered scoring chances in the fourth, fifth, and sixth before finally breaking through with the tying run in the seventh. 0-2. Sisitko, fly ball, hanging up for Aiden Espinoza in center. And Aiden Espinoza makes the catch to give Otto Espinoza his first out.
And for Otto, second sophomore that's been out on the mound today for Huntington Beach. Really impressive that they've got underclassmen that can do what they've done here in this game.
So base is clear, one down for Andrew Lamb. Smacked a double in the fourth inning. He's also flown to center and struck out swinging. Getting toward a good part of the order for the Lions as the lineup card flips over here. Espinoza's first pitch. Breaker falls in for a strike. 67. Thanks to Pocket Radar for providing the in-game pitching velocity equipment used during NHSI games here at the NTC. Pocket Radar, official supplier of USA Baseball. 0-1. Almost hit him. Espinoza ready to go. 1-1 pitch. Lamb shoots it foul for a strike.
Lamb does this thing after every pitch where he drops a bat, puts his hand in the dirt, rubs him around, and then gets back in the box. It's something he's going to have to get rid of once he gets into college.
That's for sure. He's not wearing batting gloves. 1-2. Swing and a miss. Down goes Lamb. Base is empty, two down. Ryusei Fujiwara coming to the plate.
The second baseman, number 35, Lou Fujiwara.
Strike one on Fujiwara, who's 0 for 2 with the sacrifice. Espinoza's pitch. Fujiwara lifts it down the left field line. That'll plunk in for a base hit. Fujiwara takes a wide turn. He'll stop and have himself a two-out single.
I think if it was his thought or his choice, he was going for two, but his first base coach was right on top of things, telling him stay put here.
So the winning run aboard, but two outs. Trent Carraway coming to the dish. He doubled in the seventh. He's also struck out looking and popped out to shortstop today. JSerra will call upon a pinch runner. And the runner is Ben Reimers.
You take the risk, put him in motion. You're not going to lay a bunt down here with two outs in the inning. So do you try to get him in scoring position?
Kind of a what do you have to lose situation near the home team.
Yeah, that's kind of where my thought is. With two outs, go ahead and see if you can't get them there. Make it where one hit wins the ball game.
Carraway, fly ball, right center field. That'll plunk down. Reimers on the move. He'll dig for three. Carraway standing at second with a two-out double. Well, there you go.
No need to put it in motion. Huntington Beach was playing a deep outfield, and luckily for them that they were able to cut that ball off before it bounced and rolled any further.
So now, Jonathan Mendez, swinging strikeout, ground out to short, hit by a pitch. A base hit wins the National High School Invitational. First pitch from Espinoza. Front door, strike one. Mendez didn't like the call.
He didn't, but in this situation, no point in complaining. Get back in the box, make the adjustment. You see that same pitch, you know you got to pull the trigger.
All sorts of space, right back up the middle and down the lines. One base hit wins it. Mendez, high fly ball, falling quickly. Coming in, Turner. He's got it. We'll go to the ninth. Two left in scoring position for JSerra after the Huntington Beach Oilers left the bases loaded in the top of the eighth. Ninth inning next.
In the eighth inning for JSerra, no runs on one hit. No errors, two runners left on base.
Where Ninth inning of play here at Coleman Field in Cary, North Carolina. Championship game of the NHSI for 2023. The Huntington Beach Oilers scored a run in the third. The JSerra Lions answered back with a run in the seventh.
Each team with an opportunity in the eighth couldn't scratch it across, and that's the story of this game.
Yep.
Opportunities with the defense just doing enough to keep the other team off the scoreboard.
Huntington Beach has left 9 aboard, 6 left on for JSerra. Brian Trujillo leads off. The second baseman's been hit by a pitch, also grounded to third and popped to first. Swing and a miss, 1-2. J.J. Hollis continues on the mound. Hollis did have the hit batter, but was able to wiggle out of trouble in the eighth, so he continues on in the ninth. 1-2. Trujillo, fly ball toward the left center field gap, but cruising over and making the catch, Sisitko.
Long way to run, but he got a good jump on it. Read it well off the bat.
One down for Tony Martinez, the third baseman. His RBI single in the third accounted for the one run for Huntington Beach. Swinging strikeout and reaching on a fielder's choice. Yeah, cut and a miss. A one. Looper hit into right field. That'll fall in for a base hit. And the go-ahead run is aboard for the Oilers.
Let that ball travel. Really trusted his hands to get through the zone.
The shortstop, number 1, Dean Carpentier.
Back to the top of the order for Dean Carpentier. 0 for 4 with 4 swinging strikeouts today. And he's played a solid short defensively, though. Been really important. Squares to bunt, pulls back, and takes a strike. How many times have we seen guys square to bunt and either stab at it and have it be called a strike or pull back and it's a strike anyway today?
Too many.
This time, swinging away, comes up empty for strike two.
Back-to-back good sliders from Hollis.
No two pitch. Carpentier fights it off foul. And Garcia waiting on deck, the designated hitter. All 4 hits for Huntington Beach coming from the bottom 4 hitters in the order, including 2 from Tony Martinez. Bouncing ball back through the middle, and Dean Carpentier, after the 4 strikeouts, has himself a base hit.
I was just getting ready to say, when you have a game like that where the bottom half is producing, you as a coach have got to feel like it's just a matter of time before somebody in that top half starts to get things going.
Maybe it's Lincoln Garcia, who's 0 for 3. Also has a walk. Garcia, then Ralphie Velazquez on deck. Go-ahead run is at second. Insurance run at first. One down, top of the ninth. Second extra inning of this championship game. Strike one.
If you're Garcia or any right-handed batter for Huntington Beach, you've got to be looking for that slider from Hollis cutting across the plate.
Upstairs, 1-1. The bullpen is quiet for JSerra. This is Hollis's ball game. Down low, ball two. Set in the 2-1. Now to the backstop.
Big shift in the outfield. The center fielder just moved over into the left center field gap. Right fielder playing in right center. Anything down the line, you can run for days.
And two. Delivery. Inside, almost hit Lincoln Garcia. Full count, one down. A walk would load the bases for the second straight inning with one out. Oilers couldn't score in the eighth. Hollis is 3-2. Looper to the right center field gap. That'll plunk in. Held up at third, and the bases will be loaded. Now it gets away. Here comes Martinez. He'll score the go-ahead run. Two in scoring position for the Oilers.
There was just an instance that JSerra didn't know what to do with the ball. Right fielder threw it in, but I'm not sure who the cutoff he was throwing to. The play should have been you're throwing that ball home. Cut off is the first baseman. Somehow that got all the way over to their own dugout.
And allows the go-ahead run to score and insurance runs at second and third.
Still just one out in the inning, so fly ball can get you another run. If you're the batter, you're just trying to pull it left-hander at the plate. Get that ball in the air right side of the field. They're just going to walk him, I think. Put the double play in order.
Yeah, intentional walk to Ralphie Velasquez. So bases loaded, one down for Aiden Espinoza.
Keeps a lefty at the plate, so pulling that ball to the right side a little bit easier. I feel like you got to play the infield in if you're JSerra. You can't play for the hope of a double play. If you have a weak ground ball up the middle, you're not going to turn two and you're just giving up a run.
The middle infielders, even with the baselines, corner infielders play in. Espinoza yanks it foul for strike one.
If you're Carpentier at first, you got to be off on contact. Just be aware of anything in the air. If it's a line drive, that's the one you got to be really wary of. But otherwise, off on contact here. You got time to recover if it's a fly ball. If it's ground ball, hopefully you beat it out.
Another one that Espinoza is just early on. 0-2. Fly ball, right center field gap. That'll drop in. It'll bounce to the wall. Everybody coming home. Espinoza to third. A stand-up. Bases clearing triple. And the oil rig is gushing. The Huntington Beach Oilers take a 5-1 lead.
There was a little bit of a shift in the outfield. Center fielder ranging towards left, Espinoza. That ball from the lefty in the right center field gap. And I think because of that little bit of a shift is why it got all the way to the wall. So maybe one extra run scores off of it. Instead of a triple, you have a double. Either way, huge hit. I said it earlier, once we got to extras, who was going to be the offensive hero? We haven't seen defenses or pitchers really give any instances of free bases away in this game.
And so now, with just one out, Trent Grindlinger becomes the seventh Oiler to bat this inning.
I think JSerra's coaching staff thought maybe somebody missed home, checked on it, but home plate umpire says that nobody missed, everybody touched.
Grindlinger strikes it foul. Well, it just felt like a matter of time before one of these teams, we weren't sure who, would come through. Infield in all the way around. One ball and one strike. Down low and away, 2-1. Oilers left the bases loaded. Didn't score in the top of the eighth. Now here in the ninth, as Grindlinger draws a walk, they have busted the game wide open.
I think Hollis has emptied his tank, second appearance of this tournament. They got a sidearm or throwing in that bullpen that they're going to go to here.
5-1, Oilers up 4. JSerra back to the pen. New pitcher coming in after this. This pitching change brought to you by Mark Pro, the trusted recovery device of over 200 major league pitchers. New pitcher for the JSerra Lions, Keaton Basso.
At the plate, the left fielder, number 31,
right-hander, standing 6'2", 175.
Like I said, when he was warming up, a side armor, so a very different look and a release point.
Seventh pitcher of the game for the Lions. He'll face Colby Turner, who squares to bunt, pops it up, runner coming home, flip to the plates, and no tag applied. Everybody safe, 6-1 game.
Squeeze play, executed to perfection right there. Completely caught JSerra sleeping, didn't expect it at all. Neither of the corners come crashing in when the bunt gets put down, and by the time the The pitcher gets there. The only play is to try and come home.
So now Bradley Navarro comes to the dish. Runners first and second and one down. Navarro, the ninth Oiler to bat this inning. Five runs home. Two more runners still out there and only one out. Navarro nearly gets hit. Ball one. Navarro tags a fly ball, right center field gap, well struck. This will split the outfielders. It'll bounce up against the fence. A couple more runners coming in, skips away. Navarro's going to dig for third. Oilers have their second triple of the inning, and the lead swells to 8-1.
They are really pouring it on now, just eating that right center field gap up.
Ryan Trujillo, he will become the 10th batter of the inning.
The second baseman, number 56, Brian Trujillo.
First pitch lifted foul for strike one. So Huntington Beach. There's still two more outs offensively here in the top of the ninth, but three outs to get in the field to their second championship here at the NHSI, having previously won in 2016. Trujillo fights it off, strike two. For a game in which we were talking about one run could swing it. That was the case in the bottom of the seventh when the Lions leveled the game, but Oilers have busted this game wide open. 1-1.
Yeah, and part of it is a discussion we went back to early in this game, and it was philosophy on how you handle a pitching staff in a tournament. I don't know that there's a right way or a wrong way to do it, but the way that JSerra has gone about things, guys not really going too deep into games, they only had so many pitchers you're going to be able to use, and what are they on, their eighth pitcher now, seventh pitcher?
Seventh of the game, yeah.
You end up getting down towards the bottom of your depth chart, and you're just going to get in trouble when that happens. Really no other way to put it for JSerra. Just ran out of arms, I think. Ran out of healthy arms.
Healthy and available, yeah.
Yeah.
Trujillo pops up the 2-2. Should be out number two. Fujiwara underneath it and has it. Runner holds at third. So Brian Trujillo has made both outs in this top of the ninth inning.
You know, I think he's going to be just fine with it as long as they continue to hold on to this one and win that medal at the end of this inning.
Tony Martinez, couple of hits. He'll be next. First pitch falls in for a strike from Basso. I think the best chance that JSerra had to win this, quite obviously, bottom of the seventh. That base running mistake looming large.
Yeah, the base running mistake, you can even go back before that. I feel like three of the last four innings before we got to extras, they had prime opportunities, and just one reason or another, every inning ended without putting a run up on that board until they got to the seventh. Now they had a runner in scoring position with nobody out twice in the middle of this game.
Didn't score either time.
And part of that is it's baseball. It's tough to hit. But the other part of it, you got to tip your cap to the Huntington Beach starter. Tyler Bellerose was really, really good for six innings tonight.
Martinez looks over for ball two. JSerra in the home half of the ninth, needing seven runs. We'll have five, six, and seven due up in their order. the count goes full. Three and two. Do it again. Payoff pitch once more. Fought off again.
Good job just getting a piece of that one to stay alive.
And Martinez works himself a walk. Men at the corners, two down, back to Carpentier. 12th different Oiler to come to the plate this inning.
Top of the order. Carpentier going to get pinch hit for?
Seems that way. As he makes his way back to the dugout.
I like this move by the coach. You've got a 7-run lead. You're in extra innings. For all intents and purposes, his thinking is they're going to go on to win this, so get as many guys into this to get the experience and to just be able to say, hey, I played in this game.
Pinch hitter will be Ethan Legay, senior outfielder. Legay has yet to record an official at bat over the course of this tournament, but chance to hit here. Strike one. Comes up empty for strike two. Basso one strike away. And Carpentier can re-enter, play shortstop defensively for the last time.
I fully expect that to be the case.
And Legay strikes out looking, and it ends the inning. But 7 runs come across for the Oilers. They're 3 outs away from winning a championship.
Oilers, they scored 7 runs on 5 hits. There was 1 error and 2 runners left on base.
Home half of the ninth inning, an 8-1 lead for Huntington Beach. They score 7 runs in the top of the ninth and now need to get 3 defensive outs to win the NHSI. Keaton Basso will pinch hit.
JSerra coach doing the same thing, getting some guys the opportunity to get in this game. If for nothing else, then in a few years down the road, they can say, hey, I played in the championship game at the NHSI.
Strike one on Basso. Yeah, cool story, if nothing else. Basso hitting for Dominic Smaldino against Otto Espinoza.
If you're an offense looking at a 7-run deficit last at-bats, the only way you can approach this inning is one at-bat at a time. Go win your at-bat and hope that you can do that 12, 13 times throughout the inning.
It's going to take a lot. One ball, two strikes. There's a defensive change at catcher for Huntington Beach. Jayton Greer, sophomore, has taken over. 1-2. Good stop by Greer. Single run in the third inning for Huntington Beach. JSerra answered in the seventh to force these extras. Strike three called. And the Oilers are two outs away. So one down. Pinch hitting now for Charlie Caruso. It'll be Dylan Martin. Martin came into play second base in yesterday's semifinal for the Lions.
Number 24, Dylan Martin.
As we wind things down here at the NHSI, we can reveal the all-tournament team. 15 members and a tournament MVP. First pitch to Martin. Ball number one. Three different Huntington Beach players. Dean Carpentier, Ralphie Velasquez, Tyler De La Rose. For JSerra, a couple of representatives as well. Trent Carraway, Matthew Champion. Great game that Champion threw yesterday.
Most dominating performance that I'd seen. Just one run and a complete game win.
Bouncing ball, right side. Good smothering stop. Throw on to first, bit wide. And Martin will be safe. Inning will continue.
It was a good job to get to that ball, knock it down. Don't panic next time, and you're going to make an accurate throw, and you'll get the out. A little bit of a, I got to get it over there quicker because there was a little bit of a bobble.
No,
another pinch hitter for JSerra, Thomas Gonzalez. Sophomore headed for the University of San Diego. So a runner aboard, one down. Continuing on with the all-tournament team. From Haggerty, Adam Ciccone. Santa Margarita, Colin Clark. From Aquinas, Bradley Gilbert. Pitch down and in, ball one. From Bishop Vero, Aiden Knack. Bishop Gorman, Gunnar Myro. Brother Rice, Bryce Nevels. From Basha, Gavin Smith. From St. Xavier, Ty Stark. Pitch least foul for a strike. From Jesuit, Charlie Sturm. Back to Brother Rice for Cole Van Essen. The MVP of this NHSI, Tyler De La Rose from Huntington Beach. Nine innings over the course of the tournament. One run allowed, eight strikeouts. Six really solid innings here in the championship today. He'll take a no decision.
The six innings that he went out there and pitched would put him in the running for MVP because he did it in a championship game. But factor in that he had three innings of hitless ball earlier to help them get to this. That's a no-doubter.
Tyler De La Rose, remember the name. Future Pepperdine Wave, just a sophomore for Huntington Beach.
Pepperdine may want to make sure they keep in contact with him. There's going to be a lot of teams that may come calling and knocking after seeing this performance.
One ball, two strikes on the pinch hitter, Thomas Gonzalez. Another pinch hitter is on deck. It'd be Cole Strain. One, two. Strike three called. So down to their final out. The Lions call upon Cole Strain, sophomore, future USC Trojan.
Coming to the plate, number 30, Cole Strain.
Otto Espinoza needs to get one more out for the Oilers to become champions for a second time. First pitch, a strike. right down the heart. Nothing in two. One strike away. Lions leveled the game in the seventh. The Oilers loaded the bases, couldn't score in the eighth. They busted open with seven in the top of the ninth. Espinoza's 0-2. Just outside.
Little overthrown. Maybe a little bit of the adrenaline running right now.
So a 1-2 count with two away. Espinoza ready to go. Fought off. We continue. The set and another 1-2. Another foul ball. The anticipation building at Coleman Field. Feels like it's just a formality now.
Yeah, but I've been in the position that Strain is in right now. You do not want to be that last out. You don't want to be the one that they're celebrating because they got you out and it's the final one of the inning.
Bouncer back to Espinoza. He'll underhand to first, and the Huntington Beach Oilers, for the second time, champions of the NHSI.
What a championship game it was. Just the second time in this tournament's history that it goes to extra innings. Great game played by Huntington Beach in order to win this one in extras. Nothing for JSerra to hang their hats about. Really well-played game on both sides. Somebody had to win it, though.
Congratulations to Huntington Beach head coach Benji Madur. They are champions here at the NHSI. Congratulations as well to JSerra for a terrific run in this tournament to reach the championship game. For Kyle Straub, I'm Matt Krause. Thanks so much for joining us here this afternoon. Congratulations, Huntington Beach, champions of the 2023 NHSI.
By following @USA Baseball on social media. And that concludes the 2023 National High School Invitational presented by the Greater Raleigh Sports Alliance. And let's give a round of applause to JSerra for their tremendous showing in this event. And congratulations again to the Huntington Beach Oilers on winning the championship. Before you head out, we would like to take this time to announce this year's tournament MVP. And this year's tournament MVP from Huntington Beach, Tyler Delarose. His tournament line pitched 9 innings during the tournament. Gave up 1 run and 8 strikeouts, and pitched 6 innings in today's championship game. And ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we would like to take a moment to recognize the 2023 NHSI All-Tournament Team. From Huntington Beach, Dean Carpentier. From Huntington Beach, Trent Caraway. Check that, from JSerra, Trent Caraway. From JSerra Catholic, Matthew Champion. From Haggerty, Adam Ciccone. From Santa Margarita, Colin Clark. From Aquinas, Bradley Gilbert. From Bishop Vero, Aiden Cano. From Bishop Gorman, Gunnar Myro. From Brother Rice, Bryce Nevels. From Basha, Gavin Smith. From St. Xavier, Ty Stark. From Jesuit, Charlie Sturm. From Brother Rice, Cole Van Essen. From Huntington Beach, Ralphie Velasquez. And from Huntington Beach, Tyler Delarose. Fans, thank you for joining us this week in celebrating high school baseball. Congratulations to the 16 teams who were invited to this event. We wish all the best of luck as you return home to compete for your respective league and state championships. And don't forget to stop by the USA Baseball Team Store on your way out before leaving town. And be sure to visit usabaseballphotos.com with the password NHSI in all lowercase letters to check out all the action photography from the event. Again, that password is NHSI in all lowercase letters. And please drive home safely.